What are your current, what's going on right now? Tell us all what you're doing right now. If you're there's any upcoming albums, if you're going to be featured on anyone's upcoming albums, what are you working on right now?
Well, actually, I just made a big deal with Juan G.
Ah.
And Juan G from yeah. Haiti.
Yeah.
And me and him just did a big deal, man, and it's going down, man. It's really finally about to be how it's supposed to be. It's just been grinding, man, the whole time. Now, about to do the new Thug Law album with the Thug Life and the Outlaws.
Yeah.
And got my solo album coming, got some artists coming, about to do some movies. I got the new Thug Law album coming out with all the Outlaws, Thug Life cats, new female clothing line, and some movies and stuff that we got going on. But me and Juan G about to do it real big.
All right, good. I want to ask you a question. This is real important to a lot of people. You're one of the few political rappers. You actually talk about stuff that happens in real life, things that most, the average person can relate to. What do you think has been happening to rap the past 10 years, I guess you'd say?
Well, I would say this. I think that, you know, the music business tries to push what they want their agenda to be. So, mm-hmm. when you got rappers who rap about something else besides some bling bling or, you know, something that got to do with some money or that type of thing, they don't want to promote that. You know, they don't think that's going to sell, which most people are smarter than the music, you know, executives give them credit for.
Right.
So, I personally think it's room for everything. It's all the way from a Soulja Boy to a Scarface. You know, there's room for everybody, man. There's no limit on the music. I don't trip off, because you kids need some kid music. Everybody can't rap like I rap.
Yeah, right.
You know, everybody can't talk about what I talk about.
Yeah.
So that's the beautiful thing about music. Can be anything that you want to talk about. You know, yeah. Nobody can tell you what to talk about. But I think that, like I said, ducks have their agenda, you know, whatever agenda they might want to be on. One year it was, you know, pro-black everything, and then the next year it was thug rap, and the next year it was, you know, something else, just dance rap and bling bling. So, I mean, the industry is way smarter. I mean, not the industry, but people, the buying public is way smarter than the industry giving credit for.
Do you think there's ever going to be a comeback, though? Do you think that eventually there will be a comeback of political rap being popularized? Do you think that's ever going to make a comeback, or do you think it's completely gone?
No, I'm going to tell you, it got to come back, because how you think Obama got in the White House?
Yeah.
They would never give us credit for that. They would never give no rappers no credit for being part of why Obama's in that White House. Because you got all races listening to hip-hop music. Hip-hop music is not just no black music, no white music, none of that. It's universal. That's what music is. They label music. They put the label on it, so they put some type of genre on it. It's music is music. It's just a different rhythm on it. That's all.
Right. Yeah.
But it's coming. You got to come back. Obama said change, so if there's going to be a change, you know it's going to be a change with music for sure.
Well, good. I certainly hope you're right, really, because to be honest with you, the only music that I've been and I'm definitely not the only person, especially here in Detroit. A lot of people aren't even listening to the mainstream rap. We're either listening to stuff that was recorded back in the 90s, or we're listening to the underground scene. And that's trust me when I tell you, that's a hell of a lot more entertaining than the mainstream that's out right now. I'm sure you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
People have heard of you pretty much from Tupac, but want to get a taste of Big Psych. What do you think your best album is? What do you think the best CD, best solo CD you have is, where someone who really never heard you outside of, you know, being maybe featured in Tupac's song, what do you think your best album is that you would want people to hear?
Tell me to go get Big Psych Daddy.
That's probably one of the best production CDs I've ever heard in my life.
Yeah, Yeah, that production on that CD was definitely
that
one
was
of my
really,
best.
That was really good. And I noticed the Better Days verse too on there that you originally recorded on Better Days, and then
Yeah, the cool thing about it, Better Days is Good Times. That song, Better Days, I just took the same lyrics and changed the song to Good Times instead of Better Days, because Better Days was my song. You know, I let Pac record it over, and when he recorded it over,
right,
let me get the song in and
Yeah, that's interesting. Johnny J, you worked with him a lot on your solo CDs, is that right?
Yeah, that's my dog, man.
What's your opinion of Johnny J? How do you remember him?
Oh, man, that's my dog, man. I'm the one who introduced him to Tupac, man.
Oh, really?
Yeah, for sure. My Evil Mind Gangsta album, Johnny J did all the music on it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I'm the one who introduced him to Pac, and, you know, Pac loved his stuff, and it was all, even to this day, man, that's why I'm so glad that I'm dealing with some cats that the fun is back.
Yeah.
So now the fun is back, because we was always having fun in the studio, man, making music, doing what we love to do, man, and that's all it's about. It ain't about, you know, trying to be the toughest guy on the planet, trying to be the best rapper, none of that. It's just having fun and just speaking on some real subjects.
So you worked with Johnny J for nearly two decades then, huh?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Jeez, that's good. It's a real tragedy when he died. The new CD coming out is are there going to be any Johnny J productions on there?
I'm trying to talk to his wife now, see if I can get some tracks from Johnny J, man. I love Johnny, man, I would be a part of my projects, you know?
Good. So everyone, I'll post the links on the website as well to get Big Psych Daddy, as well as the other ones. I'll post the links to all your CDs so people can buy on Amazon.
Sure.
That's probably the prime place to buy the CDs at. You said you just signed with Ron G just recently, so you're working with him right now, and you said you have some movies coming out, or you may be featured in some movies. Can you tell us a little bit about that, if you don't mind?
Well, basically, just some straight to DVDs, and we got a big project that we ain't gonna speak on going to the silver screen.
Oh.
But it's really just a lot of, independent stuff, man. That's what I love, independent, so I can stay in control of my debt.
Right, okay. Tell us about the CD, Black Thunder.
That's gonna probably come out sometime either later this year or next year. I did that with a company called Treacherous Records.
Is that going to be coming out, so that's not going to be under your new label, that's going to be under an old one?
It might. I'm trying to work out a deal with that album right now, but it's definitely coming out.
Okay, good. Definitely keep us in tune with that. We'll follow up without a doubt. Big Psych, we really, really appreciate the interview and the time. Anytime when your CD comes out, I will definitely follow up. And if you don't mind, if we could talk a little bit more about your upcoming projects, that'd be great. Especially a CD when it's going to come out, Black Thunder.
Yeah, without a doubt. I'll keep you updated on everything moving, man. Like I said, be on the lookout for Ron G album, the new Thug Life Outlaw album, and Nickel Nut. That's a young artist that I'm working with from my neighborhood, and the Big Psych and the Mussolini Outlaw album.
Do you still, just one last question, do you still work with some of the original members of the Outlaws?
I've got an album coming out with them, all of them, man. Fatal, Edie, Noble, Castro, Macadosis from Thug Life, Mo Prince, everybody, man, we all getting together.
Whatever happened to Storm?
Storm is right around here somewhere, man. I talked to her one day, man. She just, you know, a lot of people just kind of let the business fade into the wind, you know. I'm trying to, if I ever see her, she's more than welcome to get back home with what we got cracking for sure.
Well, again, Big Psych, thanks a lot. We really appreciate it. And everyone, thanks for listening.